So Affinity Designer 2.4 is now out. Let's see what's new. So the first update I like is the ability to set the selection box permanently. What do I mean by that? Well, take this crazy shape for instance. The shape around it here is our bounding box, and right now it would be pretty difficult to snap up to this straight edge here. What we could do in the past was just press full stop on the keyboard, and then it gives us this bounding box, and then we could just bring it up and snap it to an object like that. But if we clicked away and then click back on it, same selection box would be there. So what do we do now? Well, click on full stop on the keyboard, and then to lock it in, we press command and full stop. And now that's permanently like that. If I can click away, click back on it and bring it up, and that's great. And we can now double click or tap to switch between the node and the move tool. So let's go ahead and try it out. So this E here, I want to bring it up. So I'm in the move tool now. I'll just bring it up. And let's say now I want to play around with the nodes. I just double tap on it and then I can see the nodes and I can make an adjustment where I see fit. And then let's say I want to go back onto the move tool. I just double click again and I can move it around again. And we can now lock our insertion targets. What do I mean by that? Well, let's take this flower for instance. Before I used to be able to copy and paste and then drag it out. And let's say I wanted one behind. Well, I delete that. I'd head on up to insertion and I click on insert behind selection, and then I press command C, command V to copy and paste, and then I drag out and you can see it's underneath. But here is where the problem was before. We could press command C, command V again, and then it would be pasted back on top again. What if you wanted to keep doing that so it's underneath? Well, let me delete these. Okay, so what you do, it's selected, you head on up to insertion, we'll click on insert behind selection, and I will hold down Option or Alt, click once, and that's locked that in place. Now I can press Command C, Command V, drag across, Command C, Command V, and you see it continues to be behind. Fantastic. And we can use the spacebar modifier for lock children. So how are we going to use this? Well, here's a sky, and inside there's some child layers. They are the clouds. If you look down here in the layers panel, that's how they look. So imagine I want to bring up the sky slightly without affecting the clouds. Right now, if I clicked and went up, you can see it would stretch it out, and I don't want that. So what we do is we click and then hold the space bar and drag up, and there we go. It hasn't affected the clouds at all. So let's try it again with this leaf here. I'm going to clip this leaf inside of this circle. So I'll just do that. So now it's inside and it operates as one. So if I just hold down on the circle, so I'm click and holding, and then I'm going to hold down the space bar, I can move it around like this. Also, if I go up to the corner and try again, I will click and hold, and then I will hold space bar, and I can drag it down. And obviously, I can hold down shift as well, so I can get it in proportion, and then move it around like so. So it makes it a lot quicker using this space bar modifier. Moving on. Okay, this part of the update is very cool because it will allow me to use the alignment tools to make all of these the same shape, whether it's height, width, or rotation. So the old way we used to align is select all of them, go up to alignment, and then I'd spread horizontally, and then I would align to the middle. And that's great, but they're all different sizes. So the new way we can do it is this. So let me just press back. So I'll select all of them. And now I want to nominate one of the ice creams or lollipops for all the others to follow. So let's take this yellow lollipop. What I'm going to do is hold down Option and click. If you're on Windows, it's Alt click. So this is now my candidate, my nominated key object. And so with this one, we'll head on up to alignment. And then we will click on spread horizontally. And then I will click on align middle. And then down here, it says make same. So if I wanted them all to be the same height, I would click on this one here. And you can see some of them look a bit skew-whiff. We need to maintain this aspect ratio. So I'm just going to click on this little box here and then apply. And you see they're all nicely laid out the same size. This is fantastic. You can do the same thing with rotation as well. So let me click off. I will rotate this one here. In fact, let's do this one. I will rotate this one and I will select all of them. And then I will go over to this lollipop here. I'll hold down Option, click, that's my candidate now. Go up to alignment and then I will go down to make same and I'll click on rotation. and you see all of them have rotated and I can just press apply and that's great. Another part of the update is that you can now space horizontally or vertically and it will now consider a key object. So I've got a few examples here. Let's go in and do the first one. So the first one I want to space from left to right. So from here all the way there, I want each of these ice creams to fit in the box perfectly centered. So the first one is perfectly centered. There we go, it's all snapped, and so is the second one. So I've done that on purpose so that all the rest of them can copy this. So what we do is click and select all of them, and then now we will nominate our key object. So I'll press Option and click on this one. So that's now selected. So it basically means that this space here will be copied across the rest of them. So we'll head on up to Alignment. Align horizontally will go to Space horizontally. I'll click on that and click Apply. And you can see they're all perfectly in their own little boxes. Okay, let's try that again on another example here with the yellow lollipops. So again, it's working from left to right, but this time we're going to choose a different key object. So I'll just select all of these lollies. And this time I have centered this lolly and the first one. And there's one in the middle here. So we're going to press Option, click on this one. That's our nominated key object. And basically what it's going to do is work out the distance between here and anything between those, it will center, and then it will do the same thing for everything on the right-hand side. So heading up to Alignment, and I will go Space horizontally. And you can see now they're all spaced perfectly. And in the last example here, we're going to work by spacing from right to left. So from this one here, this one has been centered already, and so has this one here. So I'm going to click and drag over all of them. And then what we're going to do now is make this one our key object. So I'm going to click on Option and click. And basically, just like before, it will work out the distance between these two from this side. And it will space them evenly. So this one will probably go there, that will go there. And then everything over on the left-hand side, it will continue to kind of repeat that spacing. So again, we go up to Alignment. And then we go to Align horizontally. But before we press Space horizontally, we're going to hold down Option or Alt if you're on Windows, and I'm going to click. And that way it's spaced it from right to left. And that's it. And Affinity Designer can now export to DWG or DXF files. So if you are an architect or work with vinyl cutters and the like, you can now export the files. So let's go ahead and look just to make sure. So we go to Export, and you see here in the drop-down menu, you've got DWG and DXF, and you have many more advanced options here to play around with. And Affinity Designer now has what's called layer states, and basically it lets you toggle the visibility of multiple layers in an instant. So this might be useful for design variations, maybe when making a magazine, or just chucking about design ideas and seeing which one works best just with a press of a button. So let's see how it works. I've made a fake magazine here, and it's called Fake Magazine, and I have an image and I have some text down the bottom. So if I go ahead and hide these, I'll show you that I have the men's version as well, men's summer tips. So basically from this, I want to create a layer state. So from this one here, I'm going to go up to Window, and then I'm going to go down to States, click on that, and now this box will appear. There it is, it says States. If I click on this button here, Add New Captured States, I click on it, I can name this. I'll just put men's for now. Okay, that's good. Now I will hide the men's section, so hide those images, and I will show the women's section as well. Okay, so now I want to make a layer state of this. So I will click on Add New Captured State, and I'll put women's. So now you can see there's two up here, men's and women's. So if I click on men's, I can quickly switch between men's and women's. So let's say you need to show somebody a few ideas without hiding and showing your layers. You could just switch between them like this. It goes a lot deeper than that as well with queries, but that will be for another tutorial. Okay, moving on. And if you head on over to Affinity's website, they lay it out very clearly, all the 2.4 updates in detail, and you can just click the drop-down arrows and look through all of this. There are a few more that I haven't mentioned, like 32-bit HDR PNG support added, improved raw processing, etc. But the majority of the ones that I thought were quite interesting, I've covered. Okay, catch you on the next one.